Hello, everybody. Thank you for joining tonight's event. We're going to discuss the difference between decentralization and like centralized options. So a centralized option would be using Binance. KuCoin does have a KYC function, which means if you KYC, you means you verify your information, and this allows you to increase your withdrawal limit. To use one of the largest exchanges in crypto, Binance, you got a KYC to just use the service. So KYC stands for Know Your Customer. Now, when you're using an application like SafePal, this is a decentralized option. That means we do not KYC. We don't store your information. The information we're using is pulled directly from the blockchain. When you make an account with SafePal, so let's click on software wallet, we can import our wallet or create a new one. And this is going to create a seed phrase. And this seed phrase is a specialty password. This allows you to import the wallet. And what that means is right now I'm using an iPhone. Now, let's say I wanted to switch phones. I bought a new cell phone and now it's an Android. Or it could be anything, actually. You can then use that special seed phrase. You put it inside the new device to recover the wallet. So without this, you will lose all your funds. You're not going to be able to download the SafePal app again and your account will be there existing. That's not how decentralization works. A decentralized wallet means you have full control of your crypto assets. So we're going to create a wallet. When you're first starting with SafePal, you're going to have to create a password. Please do not use this password. This is only for testing purposes. Press confirm. And then we're going to generate a mnemonic phrase. That's another name for seed phrase. Click generate. And then you record this. So this is your actual seed phrase, what I was talking about previously. Remember, this is the most important thing you own in crypto. You have to back this up. In this video, I'm not going to, but for you, the everyday user, you have to. If you delete the app, lose your phone, or want to import your wallet without this, there's nothing we can do. Because at SafePal, we do not store any of this information. So we're gonna click skip for now, but please do not do this yourself. We can name the wallet. Press confirm. There we go. We have created our wallet. At the top here, you could see we have the name of the wallet. And then you see the AD8. That is the suffix. What that means is it's to identify different wallets. So you can import as many wallets as you want with SafePal. And you know, you may want to have it named different ways. It could have the same name. But the suffix, the AD8, is unique for each wallet. That's a identifier to let you know this is a different wallet. This is also a security feature. Why? Because let's say tomorrow this AD8 changed. Well, then I know that this wallet has been compromised. That means someone imported this wallet somewhere else and is playing with the account. So if you notice this changes, please transfer your crypto out to a new wallet as soon as possible. These are the different cryptos. You can add and remove whatever you want. This is just the standard. As you can see, SafePal is at a good price right now. It's been really popular recently, so that's great news. Speaking of SafePal, an SFP token, we are doing a 1 million SFP campaign currently, and you can go on our main Twitter account to participate. We have 7 tasks only. So if you have any friends, you're welcome to invite your friends, and that is one way for you to earn shares. Anyways, let's add and remove tokens. You can sort by value, name, and by the amount you own. I prefer by value normally. And you can click manage coins and select which tokens we want. There we go. Oh, I want to remove them. Okay. Done. It's that easy. You could store your NFTs, DeFi. DeFi is generally when you use like SafePal Earn. This is you store your tokens in the SafePal app and will pay you these interest rates. These are different pairs. This is our SafePal swap. You have, let's say, Bitcoin and you want to swap it into anything you want. I don't know, I want Ethereum. Make sure you watch out for the chains. So this is Ethereum ERC20. This is ERC BEP20. So this is on the Binance chain. We don't want that. We want the normal one. And then you would swap. The app automatically looks for the best quote. What does that mean? Is we have different providers. So this is going to be when you use the swap, it will swap through this exchange, the MEXC. We also have different providers. You could do it through Binance, 1inch, and OX. But we'll also say that these trading pairs are not available. But in general, you have different options. So if you want to, you need to use KYC to be able to use this swap. You do not need KYC using the MEXC. DEX stands for Decentralized Exchange. So the same way SafePal is a decentralized wallet, decentralized exchange means you don't need to KYC. Now, MEXC is considered centralized exchange. Why? Is if you want larger limit, withdrawal limits, you need to KYC. But for just normal swaps with the SafePal, we will approve it, and they are allowed certain limits without KYC. But if you use 1inch or OX, this requires no KYC at all. So that is the difference. If some people find it important to use DEXs, if you don't care, then just use the CX option and whatever is the best rate. But if you prefer for more discrete transactions, then always select the DEX options. Over here is the DApp. As you can see, this is the SafePal airdrop. You can click on that if you want more details right here. And all the DApps we have. DApp stands for Decentralized App. So that means majority of these apps don't require KYC. But we do allow you to search whatever you like. So you could just click on the search at the top, the search bar, and you can insert whatever link you want. But remember, we're not responsible for the use of third-party apps. So if you use a PancakeSwap, Moonpot, Uniswap, whatever you choose to use, and if there's any issues with your transaction, then you need to go directly with the project itself because they're the one making the transactions. You're using SafePal app to access this app in a more convenient way, but the actual transaction itself is done by this individual project or by the app. So keep in mind that when you're using third-party apps, you are assuming the risk. We don't guarantee that you use a third-party app here that it's 100% safe, especially if you put in a random link in the search bar. Generally, if you see it here, it is safe and we deem it as a good application. But if you just search a random link, you are taking a lot of risk. So please keep that in mind. You can check the markets, what the prices are right now. So today's a good day. It's pretty green. And you can add favorites. So you can favorite your coins to decide which ones you want to track on a regular basis. So click on wallet, coin, NFT. So you can buy, let's say, NFTs on OpenSea and then send it to a different wallet. So that is an option. So you can see them and your NFTs will be displayed in your wallet. Different coins. And that's it. That pretty much sums up how to use SafePal app and all the main features that we offer. Now I want to take a moment and discuss some recent scams that we see. There's a very popular scam about SafePal part-time job. And what this is basically they say, come promote, do this, or if you store X amount of crypto, we're gonna pay you back. Like, it's really, really fake. And these tend to be on like WhatsApp, sometimes Telegram or TikTok. And yeah, it's like a fake job and they'll pay you, let's say the first time, they'll give you, let's say $10 or $20. And then you'll be like, oh, this is great. And then you put additional funds in and then you'll not be able to pull out that additional funds. So that's how that works. Or another popular one is like SafePal mining. And they're like, we pay a daily interest of 5% or daily interest of 1%. No. In our SafePal earn, sure, but that is not paying 1% a day. If you look at the numbers, it's not even close to that. Normal projects, established projects, are not going to be paying those type of rates at all. That is not realistic. So again, you would put money into a fake website or fake app, and they may use the dApp SafePal link, and they'll be like, oh, type in this link in the search bar, right? It's kind of like Google. You could search whatever you like on Google. And the only thing Google does is warn you if there's something wrong with the website. And that's the same thing with SafePal does. It does warn you when you're using third-party apps to be careful. We have included a function that does look for scams and dApps and filters those out. And if you do see any of these scams, please report it so we can add it to our filter. So I just wanted to stress the importance of this. So I resetted the app to get this message. Risk note, you didn't back up your mnemonic phrase, also known as seed phrase, for video live stream wallet. I was testing another wallet, so we had that additional wallet right there. For asset security, please back up. Understood. I'm not going to do that right now, but just to stress the importance, please back up your seed phrase. Do not store it in your cell phone or on your computer. It should be written down on a piece of paper or a SafePal cipher. SafePal cipher is a metal device where you're able to store your seed phrase inside for extra protection, because it's fire and acid proof compared to, let's say, a paper, and the paper gets damaged. But yes, never store it online for results of maybe hacking or something gets compromised. To wrap up what I previously said, we have a scam filter, and if you see anything, we'll add and keep building this filter to keep protecting our users. So you ask yourself, how do I watch out for scams? You know, what do I do? Well, you got to go to safepal.com. That is our main website, and that's how you're going to get everything you need from official sources. Only go to official sources of SafePal. If you're not sure, check, please. We have many official accounts. We got our biggest social media account is on Twitter, and then we got our website, safepal.com. So those are the two things you need to check first. If you don't see that news there on those platforms, then there's a good chance it's fake or something is off. So please keep in mind, only grab information from official sources. And that's for anything related in crypto. You need to do your own research and always verify every single project you invest in. Because if you invest in a fake token or you minted the latest NFT and there's something wrong with the NFT, you know, either there was a mistake or it was a scam. Generally, if there's a malicious smart contract that you signed, your money is gone. When you sign a smart contract, you're giving scammer permission to my wallet. You're basically saying, yes, you have access to my whole thing. So a bad project is going to have that type of malicious agreement in the smart contract. So you got to watch out for that when you're interacting with certain projects. And that's one way someone can steal your money, is you invest in a token that was not legit and they stole your money. And we're unable to recover in those certain situations. Generally, what I do for safety is I have three wallets. I have my SafePal S1 hardware wallet for assets that I don't plan on touching long term. So I put money in my SafePal hardware wallet and I just don't look at it. It's just there. And then I have another account, software wallet, for tests. So this is for all the sketchy things that I want to experiment with, that unproven latest NFT mint, latest token, that maybe something's wrong, right? It's like, for example, the project might be legit, but a hacker found an exploit in the chain because it's unproven. It's a new project and people got hacked and lost their money. You know, that project could have been legit, but because of certain technical mistakes that they made that was exploited, people lost their money. So it's not just for scam tokens, whatever. Like, even big projects can suffer issues. Generally, this happens on newer projects, though. So just because a new project might not be a scam, but there's still high risk investing in these. So again, I like to have a special wallet for these type of things. You can make unlimited, so you don't have to cap yourself one wallet for everything. So for risky projects, risky investments, I tend to make separate wallets for them. So if anything happens, it's unfortunate. Let's say I lost $50 or $100, whatever I invested in, but I only lost that amount. And generally when I invest in high risk projects, it's money that I can personally afford. I never invest beyond that. So keep in mind too, you don't want to keep all your money in one wallet. In case something happens, well, it sucks to lose money. It's not a good feeling, but it's a better feeling to know that, well, I only lost 5% of my overall portfolio than 100%. You can't recover 5% relatively quickly in crypto. If you pick the right thing, you get lucky, you can recover 5%, but 100%, game over. So to wrap up tonight's event, thank you for coming. Come check out SFP Airdrop. And if you have any questions, please ask away in the YouTube comments. More than happy to answer anything that you may have. Have a great day and talk soon.